So
Over to
yes,
you.
I think let's start with the topic of today, which is smart conversations with dialogue flow, which is chatbots, call bots, and more, right? So that's the theme, and I'm moving next. So the agenda for today is that we'll be covering, we'll be actually looking at what are bots. I'm sure everybody has looked and wondered and even sort of maybe used different types of bots earlier, which are deployed on different platforms. Let me give you an example. Let's say whenever you open a travel booking website or some website of any product or service, you actually get a pop-up, a very small pop-up from the bottom that what do you need help with, or let's say what do you want to do, right? Sometimes traditionally there is a person who is actually sitting on the back end who is actually asking you that question, but I think now in the age of artificial intelligence and machine learning, most probably you are going to talk to a bot who is going to greet you, ask you what do you need help, what do you want to buy, whether you have any purchase query or let's say any service query or any product query, and then he's going to help you accordingly in terms of either routing that conversation to actual human or anybody else, right? So I think that's how the bots are working, and I'm sure you would have also experienced bots sometimes on, let's say, messaging applications like Facebook Messenger or Google Chat or your Slack or different. You would have also observed sometimes on WhatsApp that there are a lot of bots built by different banks, right? So that you can get your status of transaction or let's say the account balance on WhatsApp itself. So all these bots are deployed. So we'll actually see what are the different types of bots, right? And I'm not going to talk much because I think later on the slides will probably speak. The second point is where I'll actually talk briefly about how bots work, and I mean how do they actually detect what you are saying and they actually give you a smart reply with the help of the dialogue flow platform. So we'll get introduced to how the platform works, what is a very basic architecture, and I think that's just going to be for probably first 10 to 15 minutes, and then we'll jump directly onto the dialogue flow platform to actually build a bot for ourselves. So in this session, that's the most exciting thing, that we'll build a very small bot, which is going to be, let's say, a travel help desk, right? Where you can actually, which can be deployed on a travel website, or which can be also be deployed on a let's say WhatsApp or Messenger. So let's say you want to come up with your own travel agency or let's say a travel booking website where you want to help customers with flight booking or let's say a train booking. So we'll actually see that how you can deploy a bot to make your life easier and obviously the customer experience also better in terms of giving them a good experience of booking something quickly and passing whatever information they want to pass very quickly. I think a quick tip here is that a lot of you who are watching this session on the mobile, if you want to actually do a hands-on practice with me on dialogue flow, I'm going to go very slow, which is where I think there's a good opportunity that you should open up your laptops or desktops or home PCs, and you can actually watch this session from the mobile, but continue working this continue going through this session on continue building the bot with me on your laptop, right? That's the advantage where you can actually build a bot by the end of the session yourself, and you can continue building on that. Even if you're mobile, if you're not having a laptop, you can actually continue watching on mobile. You might not be able to build on dialogue flow from your mobile, but then you can note down the steps and you can do the practice later on, right? So that's probably the agenda for today. So let's start with bots, but I think I'll just pause here for a while to check if there are any questions around from the viewers, any preferences in terms of language or anything. You can hear me? Yeah, just display on the on my tab itself, whosoever is the moderator, so that I get to know in terms of if there is anything coming from the users, right? So I think let's start directly with what are the different types of bots. And I think the most traditional one, which I just talked about, and I'm sure you would have observed a lot, is the chatbot, where I think you actually chat, the medium of the interaction is chat, right? So if you see the different types of bots are, why I'm saying that these are different types, because they are basically categorized into different mediums of interaction with the bot, right? You can actually type and like do like a chat, or you can also talk to a bot with the help of, let's say, a voice assistant or a call. So that's, I think, the next type of bot, which is the voice assistant one, where what you're going to do is, I'm sure you would have used Google Assistant, or let's say Alexa or Siri for Apple devices, and I'm sure nowadays you know a lot of smart devices, like we have smart bulb, or let's say a smart television, or let's say a Chromecast, Nest audio devices, Google Home devices, or let's say Alexa devices at our place, where we actually interact with them, right? So what you see is just a bot, but a different type of bot, which is a voice interaction, interactive bot, is deployed for these hardware devices. But the platform or the bot which is running at the background is probably the same, which is already there in a chatbot, or let's say in, already in other mediums, right? So it's just a different medium. Let's quickly jump on to the next one. And the next one is call bots. So I'm sure if you have used call bots earlier, or have come across any bot earlier, whenever you call a number and you are actually greeted by a bot, and they ask you to what do you need help with. So call bots are very common with a lot of customer support and customer service platforms, and a lot of products use it. And I'll actually show you a very real demo which I just recorded today, in terms of I wanted to web check in for a flight ticket, and I called one of the airlines, which is SpiceJet, and I asked them to like actually web check in, and I was not greeted by a call center or a contact center human, but rather a agent, which is a virtual agent, right? And the last one is ad bots, right? So the ad bots are basically the ones which are, like, I'm sure you would have observed a lot of times on Facebook or on different blog websites, there are ads, and then within the ads there is a option for you to actually type something, and you can pass any information, or you can ask anything about what is the price of the car, or let's say what is the mileage, or anything if it's a car ad, and then obviously you can get more information. With this means, what the bot is doing is basically taking your information, noting down that you are interested towards buying a new car, and that all information data is going to pass to a sales team representative, who is going to contact you soon for pitching, right, or a demo session. So that's how a lot of ad bots are deployed, and we'll actually even see a more few examples of how these bots are integrated with different platforms. And I'm actually going to show a very interesting demo of a call bot as well. So just be with me. Yeah. So the first one is chatbot, right? And I think I probably talked about it. This can be integrated with Google Chat or Slack or Facebook Messenger or WhatsApp as well, right? So you can type whatever you want and you can talk to a bot. The next one, Alexa, which is like assistance bot, which is, let's say, Google Assistant or Alexa or Siri. And there are probably a lot of hardware devices where you can also integrate these and interact with them. Right. And I think this is the most interesting one, which is the call bots. So these are integrated with, let's say, the IVR systems or contact centers. So I'm sure that a lot of times you have interacted with a traditional kind of I would not call it as a bot, but because it's not small, not smart, but it's more of a voice interactive system, where you actually get options like press one for this, press two for this, press three for this, and all these options, right? So this is what is called a very traditional DTMF IVR bot. But nowadays you actually get call bot, so you don't have to actually go through all the irritating options of press one for this, press two for this, and press three for this. Rather, they are smart bots where you can actually interact with bot reservation systems, and I'm going to actually show one of them to you very soon, right? So let's play a call recording. I'm going to play it from my computer, so if anybody cannot hear me, just let me know so that I can change the medium. I'm going to play it right now.
This is Stefa. How may I help you today?
I want to book my flight and I cannot book it.
That's about making a new booking. Is that right?
No.
Maybe a little differently. Please tell me the reason for your call.
Actually, I want to bed check-in, not a new booking.
That's about online check-in. Is that right?
Yes.
Okay, one moment, please. Your call is being transferred. Please, who on the line? Or our customer?
Yeah. So I hope you can see, and you could hear the demo of a call bot where I am actually not talking to a agent or a real human or a person, but rather a bot who is asking me that whether I need help with a new booking or a web check-in or changing my seats, and based on that they actually pass my call to a representative who can help me quickly, right? So which means that the customer experience is better, and obviously the agent talk time has reduced in terms of they don't have to pass calls between different people who can help me out with that issue. The bot has figured out what I need help with, and then they have help me around in that. So I think that's how the call bot works. I'll just see if there are any questions or anything. Yes. Okay, great. I think a few people are mentioning that I can speak Hindi or Punjabi as well. So I'll maybe kind of try to mix both of these. So abhi tak I am sure everybody knows that rephrase in Hindi as well, and kind of before going next. So different tarah ke bots hote hain, jaise ki call bots and chat bots or ad bots or voice assistants, and or abhi jo hai hum inko different platforms mein deploy kar sakte hain, right? तो अभी हम देखते हैं कि बॉट्स वर्क कैसे करते हैं, हाउ डू दीज आर वर्किंग. सो लेट्स से हम एक बॉट से बात कर रहे हैं, एंड वी से द बॉट व्हाट इज द वेदर राइट नाउ, राइट? सो यू कैन सी दैट ऑल दीज ट्रेनिंग फ्रेजेस गो टू अ एजेंट, राइट? एंड व्हाट इज अ एजेंट हियर? एजेंट इज एक्चुअली रिप्रेजेंटेड और काइंड ऑफ अ डायलॉग फ्लो और अ गूगल डायलॉग फ्लो वर्ड फॉर अ बॉट, right? So anywhere I'm mentioning the word agent, you can understand that that's a bot. So if there's a what's the forecast and what is the weather right now or what's the temperature, all these three sentences are similar, right? Which means these are similar ways of saying the same thing, right? For example, even let's say I'm interacting in another language, and I can interact with a bot like kal mausam kaisa hoga, yeah, kal barish hogi ya nahi, right? So all these are different ways. So what we do is we actually train our bot on all the training phrases. So we actually call all of these user utterances as training phrases, which means that we actually feed some of the phrases from our side to the bot so that it can train it can train on, let's say, the first 10 sentences, and then it can obviously it can try to figure out what the user is saying in the next turn, right? So that's how a bot works. I'm sure, like, you can even imagine how we actually teach a new language to a child, right? We actually try teaching them a few sentences so that the child can make the new sentences or themselves, right? So that's how we actually learn. Or agar hame maths ke question karne hote hain to hum kuch around, let's say, plus ke 10 sums or minus ke 10 sums karte hain taki exam mein koi bhi naya sum aa jaye to hum usko solve kar paye, right? Plus or minus ka. Similarly, bots ko bhi hum aise hi train karte hain, hum kuch phrases unhe de dete hain so that bot gets trained and it can identify what is the intent. Intent matlab wo bot karna kya chahta hai ya हम क्या पूछना चाहते हैं बॉट से, वो फिगर आउट कर पाए. हो सकता है हम उससे टेम्परेचर पूछ रहे हो, या ये भी हो सकता है हम बॉट से पूछ रहे हो कि इस कंट्री में अभी टाइम क्या हुआ है. फॉर एग्जांपल, सिंगापुर में टाइम क्या है या फिर यूएस में टाइम क्या है, राइट? सो वी कैन आस्क द बॉट एनीथिंग एंड बेस्ड ऑन व्हाट वी से बॉट इज गोइंग टू रिकॉग्नाइज दैट आई नीड दिस और आई नीड दिस एंड बेस्ड ऑन what they recognize is they are going to extract some information from us, right? Let's say they are going to extract time and location if we are asking about the temperature. They are just going to ask location if we are asking about the time or anything, right? So they ask all these parameters and then they try to, like, pass on the information to the backend, get that information and then pass it on to the user. So that's how it works, but I'll show you a better graphic to learn. So let's say now we see that the first step is end user expression. So end user expression is jo user bol raha hai bot ko, right? Ab bot ko user ne kuch bola, ab bot ke paas maan lo teen intents already saved hain jis pe humne bot ko train kara hua hai. Maan lo humne bot ko train kara hua hai ki time kya hai is country mein, टेम्परेचर क्या है इस कंट्री में, और लेट्स से द थर्ड ऑप्शन इज कि इस पर्टिकुलर कंट्री में इलेक्शंस कब होने हैं, राइट? नेक्स्ट इलेक्शंस कब होने हैं, सो, और लेट्स से इस कंट्री में अर्थक्वेक्स कब आए थे लास्ट टाइम, एंड या अर्थक्वेक्स का क्या रिकॉर्ड है, राइट? सो लेट्स से हम डिफरेंट चीजों पे हम ये सारी चीजें अपने बॉट में इंटेंट की तरह सेव कर देते हैं हम उनको, और हम वो करेंगे भी अभी. Just in after a few slides, we'll actually create a bot and we'll save some intents. And each intent, for each intent, let's say there is an intent of location, weather, mausam ka intent hai, to hum usme different phrases dalenge ki kal mausam kya hoga, ya kal barish hogi ya nahi hogi, ya kal kitna temperature hoga, kitni humidity hogi. Ye sare phrases hum save kar dete hain so that whenever user says something, based on the keywords which the bot is going to detect, the bot figure out the right intent. Let's say the agent which is a bot here, they find the right intent, and for each intent we have some training phrases, as I mentioned. So I'll actually show you. Let's say for weather application we have the intent called forecast intent, for let's say any bot which is going to help the queries with the weather. And then there are some training phrases. Right now there are three, but ideally we would add at least 6 to 7 training phrases for each intent. And then you get some parameters from the user, right? So hum user se kuch parameters le lete hain. Maan lo humne bola ki kal temperature kya hoga, to obviously the date, time and location are the three parameters which the bot needs to take. Sometimes we don't say the parameter. Let's say hum bolte hain ki what is the weather, right? Or what's the forecast? Then the bot is going to take some pre-default values, right? Let's say main usko location nahi batata, to bot meri current location, agar uske paas permission hai location detect karne ki, to wo detect karke that is going to pass me on the look let's say temperature of that location, or they will ask me for permission, or they'll ask me a location question, right? That what is your location. So they actually try to get some parameters. If the parameter values are not there, they actually take the default values. And what the next is happening is that uske baad the bot takes the action, right? And the action can be, let's say in this case the intent is forecast weather intent, then the action is that the bot sends your query to the backend API, or let's say it's just a Google search, or maybe a API of a private website, whatever information you need. Let's say it's a travel booking website, they'll probably send the information about when do you want to travel, which is your date, your arriving, and the destination city and the source city. These three things they'll pass on to the travel website so that they can show you different options of flights or train tickets available, right? So that's the action. And once they get the reply from the API, then there is a response, right? So what is the response? The response is, let's say in this case it's going to rain tomorrow, or whatever response they get from this thing. We all these responses we actually feed in a particular format to the intent, ki agar ye intent ho to ye response dena hai, lekin us response mein jo bhi parameters ki value hai ya fir jo bhi value hume bahar se external API se aane wali hai, hum usko uski jagah sirf ek empty entity fill karte hain, so that the values can be filled and it is going to pass on to the user, right? So let's say if it is a temperature, the response will be that the temperature at XYZ location is N degree Celsius, right? So N we will probably get from the backend call, and XYZ location we'll get from the user, right? So that's how a very basic flow of a bot work. And how we do all these things, like where do everything works? It works on the Dialogflow platform, which is, and we'll just like probably look at what is the what is kind of the architecture of bot creation of Dialogflow, and then we'll jump to the bot creation directly, right? So I'll just pause here and see if there are any questions, anything. Yes, I think so. There are a few questions on how can someone create a chatbot. I think probably after 5 minutes you will get the answer of this, and you will actually create a chatbot with me if you are having a laptop and you can log in along with me. Is there any language specified? So the good answer is that I'm not going to actually create a bot from scratch, let's say without using any platform, using any languages like Java or Python, but rather what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a Dialogflow platform, which is more of a configurational platform. And this is, I think the slide also represents the Dialogflow is a natural language understanding platform that helps to design and integrate smart bots, right? What does this mean? Is that you can actually design and integrate bots and it's more of a configuration rather than a coding activity, right? So you actually configure a bot, not rather code it using any programming language. And that's the best thing. I'll tell you that I have seen a few people who have even created bots on Dialogflow who are not even engineers or not from engineering background, right? So they are doing their own business and they want to actually deploy a small bot on their messenger application, so that if anybody is actually reaching out to their Facebook business Facebook page, they can actually message and the bot can reply to them, because they generally receive a lot of queries, right? So that's the best thing about Dialogflow. And I think the next one is there's a question on create chatbot in Google Cloud platform. Yeah, so Dialogflow, as I mentioned, that is a platform which is powered by Google Cloud, right? So you can, whenever you work on Dialogflow, you will see that that everything on the backend works with Google Cloud only, right? Is it having any drawback? In terms of drawback, I'm just there's no drawbacks as such. It's just that how complex a bot you are going to make and how you are taking care of the security and the privacy issues. Because I think particularly the organization I come from, which is Google, we actually take a lot of security and privacy things with utmost care. And what we do is with every application, let's say it's a bot or it's anything, any other application, you need to make sure that you are respecting the user privacy and data, and you making sure that whatever information is going to pass on to the user is going to pass on, you're sort of storing it on the back end. Obviously, everything is taken care of by Google Cloud, but it's just that you should make sure that is always taken care of, right? So I think a lot of people are mentioning that I should talk in Punjabi as well. So I just try. But I think speaking three languages slightly difficult. But yeah, let's move next. Let's see what the dialogue flow agent architecture is, right? And that's the last slide before we actually go to the hands-on session. So just be with me for a few more minutes and then we'll build a bot. Very quickly. So that's how a user agent actually works on Dialogflow, and that's how an end-to-end conversation happens, I should say. So let's say there's a user which is in the first step. He is saying an expression. Wo kuch expression bol raha hai, he's going to pass through a input channel, which is let's say a phone call or a computer, laptop, or via a voice assistant, and that utterance, user utterance, is going to be passed to the Dialogflow platform, and Dialogflow platform ke pass wo intent chala jayega ki that expression chala jayega, and based on whatever intents you have created, the agent will try to match ki kya intent hame hum kya hamara kya intent hai conversation ka, yani ki hum kya chahte hain. Let's say it's a train booking conversation. I want to book a flight or a train. They will identify, and based on it will interact with me to get whatever information the bot needs, which they need to pass to the backend. So you can see this is the Dialogflow interface and this is the fulfillment part. What does fulfillment means is that whatever interaction is there with external APIs or database is called fulfillment, that interaction activity, right? So Dialogflow is just going to pass on that request to the fulfillment through Google Cloud or any external, let's say, APIs or cloud platform. And then whatever information is passed and there are some actions which are taken, and whatever the response is, that webhook response is going to be passed on to the Dialogflow through its API, and that response is going to be given out to the user, and then the interaction happens, right? So that's how probably an agent works. A lot of bots are very basic, jisme fulfillment hota hi nahi hai bilkul bhi, right? Usme sirf end user hota hai aur ek Dialogflow intent matching hota hai, aur we try to help without a fulfillment. For example, let's say you just want to interact with the customer and help them with how to do anything, right? Let's say you have a website, but the customer still interacts and asks, how can I cancel my service, or how can I return my product? And you can actually save responses in terms of you need to go on this link, and you need to say this, or you need to go on this menu, go on this item, and you can click there and return it, right? Which means that you don't need to take any information and pass it on to the backend, or let's say interact with the APIs. And this is how I think you can create your own chatbots also in the starting, where you can actually just create basic chatbots and deploy them on, let's say, Google Assistant, because that's the most easiest thing to do while working on Dialogflow. So I'll just not talk a lot and come to this stage where we are actually going to build a bot, right? So I hope everybody is there, and I think they're excited to start off with the hands-on thing as well. So I'm just I think this is the link all of you need to open, which is dialogflow.cloud.google.com, and then let's start off with the hands-on stuff, right? Which is after you are opening with this. I think I would appreciate if people can actually write on the chat in terms of whosoever is using a laptop and working along with me on the Dialogflow platform, so that I can go slow and you can actually let me know if I should move ahead while doing this. So I think that's something everybody can do. So yes, so I think just say a yes, or say something like I am going to build with you on the chat, so that I get to know that everybody has opened their laptops and they have opened this link, which is dialogflow.cloud.google.com. And I'm also going to open the same link and logging with a new account, so that you can follow my steps, right? So that's, I think, how I'm going to do. So dialogflow.cloud.google.com. I have received, I think, one or two comments around working with you. I think, yeah. So I think there are a few more. So I'm just waiting for all of you to open this, so that next, I think, whatever time we have in terms of around 50 minutes, we'll spend creating a bot by ourselves, right? Yes. Great. I think a lot of comments are in, so I'll rather stop sharing this presentation. And I'll share my real screen and ask the moderators also to share this screen with everybody, where everybody can actually build, see the screen and build with me. I'm right now sharing the entire screen, so I hope everybody is able to see this page, which is dialogflow.cloud.google.com. If you cannot see, can you please comment? Or just, it would be great if moderators can tell me if they can see this, if this is like, this is streamed on the live channel, right? So I'm going to sign in, click on sign in. You will see the different options of login via any Gmail ID. Since it's a Dialogflow platform, which is powered by Google Cloud, so the only option you have is to sign in with your Gmail account. So you can sign in with any Gmail account. I'm going to use a new account, so that everybody can see how a new platform, I mean, how to follow the steps. Okay, I think I opened with a previous account. Give me a second.
Audio on kar de yahan pe. Current, I can only see your desktop. We're not able to see your browser window or whatever it is you're viewing.
Okay, you cannot see my browser window?
No.
I'm actually sharing the full screen. So you can see it now. Okay, let me just remove this. Give me a second and let me try. You can see now?
Yes, now it's visible.
Okay, got it. So just give me a second and let me configure it from the start for each one of you, so that you can look at from the starting. Give me a few seconds. And I think meanwhile, everybody can open and try to log in with their Gmail accounts. Right. Just give me a few seconds. Yes, so we are I think they can let me actually share my screen again so that everybody can see it. Yes, so just confirm if you can see this now. And I'm going to log in, but I hope everybody is able to see this screen. Can someone confirm so that I can move ahead? Yes, I am hoping that this is working. So I'm just moving ahead. Just let me know if you cannot see this. And if you see, I can right now sign in via Google. And this is the platform. This is the page you will see whenever you log in from a new account. And if you have not used Dialogflow before, so you will see this terms and conditions, which are standard terms and conditions for Google Cloud and Dialogflow for any new Dialogflow project. Right, and you can accept the terms and conditions, and you can see this page where you will see this option of create an agent, or let's say you have an option here as well, which is creating an agent. What make sure that whatever you are using Dialogflow Essentials version, right now there's a new version which is also launched, which is Dialogflow Customer Experience or CX, but I think Dialogflow Experience is something you can use because they, and you can later on explore Dialogflow CX as well, right? Once you are used to creating a bot, and you can create a new agent and just name it. Let me name it as Travel Help Desk. So that's the name of the agent, or you can say a bot here, which I am creating, and I'm clicking on the saving link, right? Which means that and you will probably see that it takes some time to save. It will show you working. What it does is that in the background, each cloud agent, whenever each Dialogflow agent, whenever you create a new agent, it is linked with a Google Cloud account, right? So new cloud project is created on Google Cloud, and I'll actually show you how you can see this. So once your agent is created, you will probably see this page of intents, and you can see this, and you will see a settings button here. So if you click on settings, you will see that this is the project ID, right? And this project ID, if you click the link also, you will see this goes to the Google Cloud platform of that particular project, which kind of supports your Dialogflow agent, right? So you don't need to work on the cloud console. That's just for, let's say, billing purposes, or just for kind of deploying your application, or integrating your application, or billing purposes. But you need to work on the Dialogflow platform itself. So let me just move ahead and go back to the intents page and start creating new intents. But I think what you can do is you can see there are two intents which are automatically configured. So I hope you can see the intent names, which is welcome, default welcome intent. What does this mean is that whenever you start any new conversation, this is the intent which is going to come, or let's say matched, right? Which means that you actually start off with the welcome intent, and based on whatever the intent response is, you can continue your discussion and create your own new intents with this option. But what I will do is right now just open off the default welcome intent page, and I'll show you what all these things are. But just I'll ask the moderators if there are any questions till now, anything if the people want to ask. Give me a second. And yes, so yes, I think people are asking about the link. There's nothing else. Please, from which option you opened Cloud Console? I think that's a question Ayman asked, so I'll just show you as well. Yeah, give me a second. Yes. So the if you see, I went to this settings button, which is here, right? And when you go to settings button, you will see a project ID here, which is a Google project ID. And you can click here, and that's where it takes you to the Google Cloud Console platform, right? Probably, and since if you are for the there for the first time, you need to accept the terms and conditions, and you can look at the project ID or project name or project number, and all these is basically supported, supports the Dialogflow agent, and you can see different options. You can add more people to this cloud project if you are building this bot with someone else and you want to co-build the same bot. You can add people on this project from the Google Cloud platform, or you can also share your bot from this option, which is share. And you can share that as a developer or a reviewer, right? So you can add anybody as a developer or a reviewer to a bot. So let me just go back and quickly start building the bot. So I think that's the most exciting phase for everybody. Let's go to the default welcome intent. And you can see a lot of there are 4 to 5 options. Yes, and I have already explained a few of them, which is what are training phases, where we train a bot on how to like write something, and there are responses in terms of what to reply back to the customer or a user if this intent is matched. Fulfillment is where you interact with the APIs, what information you need to pass. I will not mostly go to the fulfillment part for this demonstration, but I think actions and parameters is what the parameters the bot needs to collect and what are the actions the bot needs to take. That's the one. And then I think the next thing is events, right, and the context. So right now I'm not going into that, but and you don't need to change that whatever default values are there, but rather what you need to just do is work on the training phrases and change the response and see how bot works, how agent works. This is a live console where you can actually try how your bot is responding, right? So you can actually see different things. So let me just open right now just training phrases and bots and responses, nothing else you need to change, right? You see there are different starting options we have already trained the bot on, right? So Dialogflow has already trained the bot and created this default welcome intent, which means whenever we start a conversation, most probably we'll start a conversation with these words, and the bot is going to reply accordingly. What the replies are, they can be any of these, right? So if you see, what this is a text response, and these are the different variants. And what does variants means? What any one of them will get select automatically by the bot and passed to the user just for the change of just for the variance, right? So let's say main hello bolunga bot ko, aur bot mere ko in charo mein se kuch bhi reply kar sakta hai. Wo bol sakta hai hi, how are you doing, or hello, how can I help you, right? So ye variants hai. Variants ka matlab wo kuch bhi reply mujhe in charo mein karega, and I can add as many variants as I can, right? So you can see this, and let's actually test this out, right? So whenever you are building something, you need to save. Because whenever you save, then only you can test it, because you will see this option of intent saved here. And let's test something. So let's write hello. So you can write hello on the console, and you will see this default response, which is greetings, how can I assist you, right? So that's the response which is given because I have mentioned it here. Let's try it again. So hello. And now the response has changed, right? So you can see whatever I say, the response has changed. You can see the text response, but let me do a very interesting activity in terms of you can actually hear your response in speech as well, right? So you need to go to the settings button, which is the this thing, and you need to click on speech, settings and speech. And when you click, once you click on speech, you will see this option of text to speech. Once you click on text to speech, you have to mark this enable. What does it represent? Is enable automatic text to speech, and you need to save this. Yeah, let's save this. You have saved this. Now let's try it again. Yes, so I'm sure you can see this interesting thing here, which is a new element, which is output audio. Let me play this for you.
Hi, how are you doing? Hello, how can I help you?
So you can see it's just the text to speech converter is like shown on the panel, on the test panel, so that you can actually see how the bot is speaking in terms of whatever the response is. If you are going to deploy this bot on, let's say, a Google Assistant or a call bot, right? You can actually change different things in terms of, you can have speaking rate, like you can change the speed, you can change the pitch and the volume, and you can even add your own voice effects using different cloud options as well. So I think you can do all these things from this speech option. Let me just go back to the intents page right now and go back to the welcome intent, right? And I'll just stop sharing and see if there are any questions till now. Right, so I think there are questions that web page is little blurry, we can't read on the phone. What I'll try is I think Saad, I'll actually try to in zoom my page so that you can look from the mobile screen, because that's the smallest screen, and I think this is a big screen on my desktop here, which is why I hope you can see this. Yes, so let me share the screen again and try to zoom, and let me know if this is working for you or not. Give me a second. Yes, I think probably this is a better version. So I hope you can see this, whosoever is on mobile, but I think this is sort of zoomed my screen, so you can see less things at a time, but I'll do this for everybody, for all the viewers. So you can see I have the training phrases are already configured, and I'll not maybe add more, but yes. So what I'll do is I'll add, you can see there's a response, but now we are actually customizing it for our own travel help desk, right? So let me delete this. So you can see the delete option here. Probably, I think, let me actually delete this. I've removed this sidebar for everybody so that they can see the full screen, a better screen. So yes, and you can delete one by one training phrases also, and you can delete all the training phrases as well. So you can see I have deleted all the training phrases, and now what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on add responses here and add a new response. And you will see this option of agent training completed whenever you make a change, which means that the bot is actually training whatever responses I am adding. So you'll probably see this option very soon again. So you don't need to click on this plus icon, because this is directly for the response. If you are integrating with any of these particular channels, you can see there are a lot of channels here, which is Hangout, Skype, Viber, Telegram, Slack, WhatsApp, Facebook, Google Assistant, Dialogflow, anything, right? But right now I'm not clicking on this, but rather adding it here, because that's a standard option and you can rather integrate your bot later on with the other platforms. So let's write this, which is you can write the response, hello, welcome to travel help desk, right? This is one response. And let me write a few more responses, which is hi, welcome to travel help desk. And we can write the other line, next line here only, but right now what I'll do is I'll actually save it and let's see if this is working. So you need to save this, wait for a few seconds because you will see this option of intent saved, and then you will see an option of agent training started and agent training completed. So I hope everybody can see this, which means that agent has trained on the new response. So let's try this. Hello. And you can see response has changed.
Hello, welcome to Travel Help Desk.
Right, and that's how your bot is responding. Let's add a new line by adding a new response here and clicking on text. Make sure you are clicking on text and not on custom payload, because that's for a different purpose, and let's not go into that. Let's write a different response, which is how can I help you today? I think we have a few minutes, only 30 minutes left. So I'll just move ahead more quickly. I think, how can I help you today? And if now let's save this and see if it is running. So we will see, and let me run it again. So let's the agent training be completed. So yes, hello, hello. So you can see the response is hello, welcome to help desk, which is one of these, and then the next line, which means that if you add two different boxes of responses, all of them are going to get displayed. But if you add just below this, that's just a different variant, which means one of them is going to show. I'll repeat again. Agar ye yahan pe dono boxes hain, to dono show honge, dono ka response user ko jayega. Lekin agar hum ek hi box mein different variants dal rahe hain, to un dono mein se koi ek jayega, right? So right now you can see there is hello, and let's try it again. And you can see again the same response. Let's see if there is a, yeah, you can see probably it's the same response. This one is not selected right now, but that's how I think. Let's add here. How can I help you today? And let's see. Oh, it's same. How may I assist you today? So these are variants, and let's see if this gets played or not. So let's just quickly let the training be completed. You'll see agent training started and completed. Make sure that you are clicking the save button every time, otherwise it won't work. Let's write hello and see, and you can see there's a different response here. Hi, welcome to the help desk. How may I assist you today? Right. Let's run it again. And there is a different response. Hi, welcome to help desk. How can I help you today? Not assist you. So any of these two will get saved, right? So probably I hope everybody is with me till now. So I'll just take again a break and stop sharing. Yes, and see if there are any questions. I think the question I mean asked is, where did you enable the speech button? I have enabled it by going to the settings button, and by clicking the settings button, you will see different options in the top bar. You will have an option of speech. Whenever you click on speech, you will see an option of automatic text to speech conversion. That's probably the third toggle, and you need to toggle it around to see it again. And I hope if there are any questions, just ask, and I'm happy to answer again. for each one of you. And let's just go back. I'm going back to the intents page, and now I'm going to create more intents. So let me zoom this again. Yes. And you will see I'm clicking on create intent here. Yes. And this is the new page you will see. And you will see all of the options are empty here for the new page. Everybody is empty. There are no training phrases, no responses. And you have to add those yourself. Right. And that's where now your work starts, and you need to train your bot yourself. Let's create a new bot, new intent, which is book a train. Right. And let's save this, which is book a train. Let me actually write it book train ticket, because booking the entire train is like slightly funny and weird expression intent name. So book train ticket, that's the intent name I'm giving. Don't put spaces in between, that's kind of a better way to write it, and I think that's what their platform accepts. I'm going to add training phrases now. So ideally you should add at least 6 to 7 training phrases, but I'll just add 2-3 maybe. But later on you can go and add as many training phrases as you want. So you can just think what the user will say agar usko train book karni hai, right? Wo bot se kya bolega? He will say, I want to book a train ticket, right? Or I want to check different options of train tickets. Can you please book a train for me, right? Let's say, need help with train ticket booking. Let's write it differently. Let's think differently. What will they say? And maybe someone says, I want a railway ticket reservation, right? So that's probably a different way to say the same thing. Railway ticket reservation. Reserve a train ticket, train seat, let's say, reserve a train seat. Anything else, anything you can add? I have already added 6 to 7 training cases, and now what I'll do is I'll just save. Make sure that you are saving continuously, so that you don't lose the information, and your bot is getting trained automatically as you are creating. So you will see this button, which is like whenever you the bot is training, it will sort of go, and you don't need to add anything in the context, events or actions and parameters. What you need to just do is you need to write the response, right? And let's write the response. So let's say bot ko bola ki we want to book a train ticket. So what will the bot reply? Right. Most probably what is going to ask the date or ask for the information on when do you want to travel. So let's quickly go and write that. I'm going to that. So thanks for choosing Travel Desk for booking a train ticket. Can you please help me with, can you please tell me your travel, tell me your travel date. Can you please tell me when do you want to travel? I think that's a better response. Please let me know when do you want to travel. Yes. So can you please let me know when do you want to travel? And what I'll do is I'll save this, and let's run the bot again. So now I'm going to, once the agent training gets completed, let's run it. Hello, hi, welcome to Travel Desk. That's the response. Let me say it again, write something else. I need a train ticket. Let's write something which is not in the X training phrases. So now you can see something very interesting, which is a user is saying that I need a train ticket, and the response is, thanks for choosing Travel Desk for booking a train ticket. Can you please let me know when do you want to travel, right? So I think that's the response, and let me play this response for you.
Thanks for choosing Travel Desk for booking a train ticket. Can you please let me know when do you want to travel?
And you will see this intent, which means book train ticket intent. What does this mean is that like the right intent is matched. So you can always see if the right intent is matched or not, right? So I think that's how you can actually create a first step. What I'll do is I'll just go back and create one more intent very quickly. The intent name is book flight ticket, right? I'm going to save this. I think there are few training phrases I need to add, but still I'll just add two. I want to book a flight ticket. I need to book a ticket with airlines. I want to fly from whatever, Islamabad to Peshawar, right? I don't know there's an airline service between these two cities or not, but I've just mentioned I want to fly from Islamabad to Peshawar. Like, these are the three training phrases. You can see something interesting, which is the dialogue flow agent bot itself has automatically detected one of the parameter values, which is, let's say, Peshawar. But right now we are not saving these parameters because we'll save these in the next step in another intent. And let me give out the response, which is, thanks for choosing Travel Desk for booking a flight ticket. And let's not write anything else, and let's just test this out. And I hope this is working. This works. So let me now write something else. Hello. So the question, this is a welcome intent. Hello, welcome. How can I help you? Now I just say, let's say, flight booking, nothing else. So you can see, okay, so this is not getting detected, maybe because the training phrases are not enough. Yes, because yes, I have not mentioned booking word, let's say, in this conversation. So what you need, and I've just mentioned flight only once, which means you need to add more training phrases. And whenever your intent doesn't get matched, you will see that it goes to default fallback, right? Which means now the bot wants you to say, sorry, I cannot get that. Can you rephrase? So let me rephrase. I want to book a flight. And you can see now the intent is recognized and it is asking me book flight ticket, right? So that's a very interesting thing, where you can see there is a default fallback intent above of the welcome intent. And let me add a few more training phrases so that it works for each one of you. Let's say flight ticket. Let me save this and let's go to the intent page, and you will see fallback, right? So that's the intent which will trigger whenever the bot doesn't understand something, right? And you can see all these are, the bot will ask you, can you please say it again so that you can rephrase it in a different way and the bot understands. You can see there are no training phrases to it, which means bot, and this intent doesn't require any training phrases. This can be configured automatically. So let me just stop sharing now and see if there are any questions around, and let me close this off. Yes. So it worked. I think it's very interesting that it is working for a lot of you, and there are no questions. So I'll not save much time. I'll not waste much time, and rather just continue with this. So let's, because I want you to build as much as you can right now in this session. We have around 20 minutes where we'll build more for 15 minutes. I'll go back to this intent page and let's complete one intent, which is book train ticket. Let's book, let's do this. So you know now the customer wants to book a train ticket, and what the what you are asking is, you are asking, when do you want to travel? So can you please tell me what will be the reply? The reply most probably will be that the date that I want to travel on 9th October or 9th November, or I want to travel tomorrow. I want to travel day after tomorrow. I want to travel after 10 days. So that the reply can be anything, right? But I think that these are how would you train a bot on different dates? So let's do that. What you need to do is go to the intent page, and you will see that you need to look at this book train ticket. And if you go hover your mouse on this, you will see an option of add follow-up intent, right? Add follow-up intent. You need to click on this. Again, I will say book train ticket, add follow-up intent. Follow-up means that's the intent which you are creating as a follow-up to book train. Follow-up का मतलब जो उसके बाद होगा. मान लो मेरी train वाली बात चल रही है, बॉट ने या एजेंट ने डिटेक्ट कर लिया कि मुझे ट्रेन टिकट बुक करनी है. अब ट्रेन टिकट बुक करनी है तो उसके बाद मैं क्या करूंगा? दैट्स व्हाट द क्वेश्चन इज, राइट? सो व्हिच इज व्हाई आई विल ऐड अ फॉलो अप इंटेंट कि इसके बाद लेट्स से देयर आर डिफरेंट ऑप्शंस, यस नो, समटाइम्स यू नीड टू कंफर्म फ्रॉम द कस्टमर दैट इज डू यू वांट टू बुक अ रियली अ ट्रेन टिकट. यू कैन ऑल्सो डू, यू कैन क्लिक yes, no intents, but I will create a custom intent, which is you need to click on custom, and now you will see after book train ticket, you will see this option of default ticket, train ticket custom, right? So let's quickly go inside this custom intent and create it. So let's first name this, right? So this is the intent where you need to ask date from the customer or a user, right? So let's write, let's name it as date, default train ticket date, and let's save this. And you need to add training phrases now. So whenever the response is that what date you need to book a train ticket, what will you probably say? You will say, let's add a date and let's see what happens. 3rd November. And you will see a very interesting thing, that the dialog flow itself has detected this as a date time parameter, and this value is 3rd November. And you can see that one of the parameter automatically gets detected here, and you can click on required option here so that you can actually say that what is the date which is when and you need to book a train ticket, right? You can click here, which means it's a required, it's a compulsory option. Let's add a few more training phrases. I want to travel on 9th December. And you will see that is also detected. Let's do something else. I want to book for tomorrow. Okay, so that's interesting that the bot has detected tomorrow as a date time entity, and it is going to take today's date, because bot obviously knows what is the date today for your time zone, and then for your country, for your location, your time zone, it is going to automatically calculate what is going to be the date tomorrow. You can also say after 10 days, let's see if this works. Yes. So interestingly, this is also working. And let's just quickly add a training phrase, a response, and then see if, like, we can ask whatever response is. So let's ask the destination city, or where the person wants to go, right? Where the person wants to reach. So let's write, okay. Let me write a second response, that let me ask from which station you want to book a train ticket. From which station you want to book a train ticket, right? And let's add another interesting response, which is let's confirm if the date is correct, right? So let's write, okay, so you want to travel on, and now the date you want to mention which the customer has said. So you can see this value, which is, you can see this option, which is value is dollar date time. So you need to mention the same here, which is dollar, and you will see this option date time. So you want to travel on date, on this date, and the bot will automatically confirm with you, right? So let's save this. I hope everybody is able to figure out. So okay, if you want, so you want to travel on this date, which is the value here. You just need to mention this and from which station you want to book a train ticket. Let's save this and go quickly to the next option. Agent training started. Very interesting. And then I'm hoping the agent training gets completed soon. You can also see that there are other options like contacts, but you don't need to add those right now. Here you can probably learn about it later. You don't need to add any events. Everything will be configured. What you need to just do is add training phrases, add response parameters will most probably automatically detect it, but you can add your own parameters also. For example, these are all system generated parameters, system saved parameters. But if I see here, if you click at the rate, you can see different options like country code, age, URL, artist, weight, airport, time, phone number, email ID, zip code, given name, last name. So you can ask, you can save anything which is automatically there, but I'll not save here. And let's run this bot and see. Hello. How can I assist you? And just write on the chat if you have any questions, or if you are not able to do. If you're able to do, then also write so that I can move ahead quickly. I'll just test this out right now. Hello. And then I'll say, let's just say train ticket. Right. So book train ticket intent. Can you please let me know what is the date you want to travel? Let's write something else. 1st January. So you can see the reply, very interesting. It has automatically detected the date 1st January 2021 from which station you want to book the train ticket. Let's hear this out.
Okay, so you want to travel on the 1st of January 2021. From which station you want to book a train ticket?
Interesting. I'll try again. I'll reset the context. Resetting means you are starting on, you are testing a new conversation from scratch. So make sure you are resetting it from here, and let's try it again. Hello. Let me just write train. Can you let me know when do you want to travel? Let's write today or tomorrow. Let's see if this works.
Okay, so you want to travel on the 19th of October 2020. From which station you want to book a train ticket?
You can see the reply, which is 19th of October. Let's try again, reset the context and add hello. Say again, hello, how may I assist you? Train ticket. Can you, thanks for choosing Travel Desk. Can you please let me know when do you want to travel? After, let me write, let me say it actually, after 5 days. Yes, I think so. If you see what the bot has detected is, I need to say after 5 days, but let's say I say 5 days. So bot is assuming that I want to travel in next 5 days. So it has detected a date range, right? Which is they'll look for options in next 5 days, but let me reset it and try again. But you can see something interesting that a range can also be selected. So hello, chain after 5 days, not just 5 days. Yes, so today is 18th. So the response is, when do you want to travel? On just so you want to travel on 23rd 10 2020, right? So I hope you can figure, you can do this till now. Let me write something again after 4 days and let's see what happens. Yes, so response has changed. So now you have added a confirmation message also. So let's say the bot identifies a wrong date and you want to say it again. You want to say not 5 days, but rather 10 days, right? So let's say after 10 days, and you will see the, so right now what happened was like the, I had tried it once. So the second time it actually went to the default fallback. So I'll just reset and try it again, but you will see that whenever you change your response, the bot will automatically detect. I'll just stop sharing, and I think there's a very small portion left because we have just 10 minutes, but I'll just, the question is, Usman is asking, where can I deploy these flows? Will it work on the Messenger and e-commerce website? Usman, yes, you can do it. I'll just show it at the end, towards the end of the discussion, how you can deploy it. But for deployment, the only thing is you need to kind of complete your Google Cloud account, and you can also get a trial account. You can also sort of get a trial student account where you can get free credits, free, let's say $100 or $50 of credit from the student account. Or for trial version, you generally get 1 month free, because there is obviously a billing involved with this. But then without billing also, you can deploy it for your own Messenger or own messaging application. The only thing is, you cannot deploy it for customers. We are deploying it for customers. There is some billing associated, but that is very, very small, like some pences or some passes for each conversation. So I think you don't need to like worry more about that. The question from Hassan is, does Dialogflow work on languages other than English? Yes, that's the interesting thing, that it works on other languages as well. You can change the language, and then you have to train your bot accordingly in other languages. You will see language options there on the settings thing, and you can even add like Hindi or English or Punjabi, Hindi or maybe Urdu words, and you can add whatever you want to add. You can add Namaste, or let's say Sat Sri Akal, which is Punjabi way of greeting, right? And you will see a bot replying. Right, and you need to add your custom recorded voices as well. Neelu is asking, can you please share your slides? I'm not sure, but I think you can check with the GDG Cloud Islamabad team. I think that whosoever are the organizers, and I'm okay to share the slides if they can share it forward. I'll share with them. Right, but I'm also going to share a few resources at the end. So just be with me. And let's complete the last part of the bot. Right. Let's just try one more thing. Let's save the city as well. Right. So what you will do is, you can see I'm going back to intents thing. And after book train ticket date, I'm going to add another follow-up intent to this one, which is book train ticket date. I'll add another custom intent, which is book train ticket date custom. And now I will ask book train ticket source station. Right. And I'll save this, and I'm going to say different stations. Let's say, where do we want to travel? I want to book from Islamabad. Let's write some few city names: Lahore, Delhi, Amritsar, Peshawar, I want to book, I want to travel from Karachi, right? So and now you can see this has detected, but if it is not detecting, right, let's say this is not getting detected, the city name is not getting detected automatically, what you just need to do is you need to select one of the city names and you will see this option. You need to search here as city. If that's the entity which is automatically saved on Dialogflow, I'll select GeoCity. And you will see that's automatically selected. Again here, if you select this, and you can select the same thing, which is GeoCity. Let's select more. And yeah, so if you see, now GeoCity is one of the option which is parameter which is created. You can create this as this thing, and let me write this also, and you will see Karachi. You can select Karachi and select that as a GeoCity. You don't need to add like a lot of city names, so that's okay. And then you can save. You don't need to, if you can add more training phrases if you want. Let's say you can write the railway station name, that this particular station you want to travel from. So I want to travel. Let's not write, and let's just quickly go next because we have very few minutes left. The response will be okay. So you want to travel from, and you can write this value which is @GeoCity. Can you please let me know your destination city? Right. And let's just quickly save and try this out. So, and similarly, you can do collect all these parameters. Let's say hello. I'm not sure. I hope bot agent training has completed. So, train ticket. Today, which station you want to book from? I want to book from Islamabad. And you can see the city is also selected, which is Islamabad, right? That's the parameter value which is saved. Now you can actually, what happens is that you collect all these parameters, let's say destination city, travel date, source city, how many people they want to travel, and say all these parameters are automatically get saved after, like later, like you, what you can do is you can click enable here, enable webhook call. And what does this mean is that let's say enable webhook call for slot filling. You can enable all of these where you can save these parameters to the backend or pass these parameters to a backend API call and call your APIs. You can complete the, you can also go, let's say, let me save this and go to the fulfillment page where you can now see is, you can see this, you can write a code for fulfillment where you can interact with the interact with APIs, but the only thing is you can complete your, you can see, yeah, I've enabling these, but to enable the webhook, you need to like add a credit account, credit card, and let's say enable your billing for this cloud project to interact with, to let's say post request or let's say receive a request, but you can obviously interact or get information from APIs for free. So you can enable this and write code, or you can interact with different things, but I think for this you need to add billing account. But I think fulfillment is not required in every bot. You can just create bot for fun, and from fun it takes me to something interesting, which is small talk. What is it? You can actually like enable this small talk for your bot if it's just a fun bot, not a commercial bot, and you can try different interesting things. So let's see. Hello, how are you doing? I'm doing very well, thanks. Oh, You are so sweet. I hope this works. Likewise. So you can see that there are different things which are automatically saved here, and the bot is trained. So let's say your emotions or your user expressions, or you just want to chat with someone as a friend, you can enable this small talk and save this, and you can like just interact with the bot for the fun sake, right? The next question was, how do we integrate this bot? So you can see this. I hope you can see this from the integrations page. You can directly deploy your bot to different platforms. You can deploy to telephony platforms for call bots. You can deploy to different messaging platforms for chatbots like Facebook Messenger, Slack, Telegram. You can deploy to other platforms like Facebook, Skype, Twitter, Google Hangouts, Google Chat, wherever you want to do. For Google Assistant, that's the most easiest one. You need to go here, which is try out the Actions Builder. And something interesting you need to do is you need to go on this Actions project. And if you go down, you will see an option of create a project. And if you create a project, it will open a Actions for Google Cloud. And once you create this project, you can integrate with your Dialogflow cloud Dialogflow agent, and then you can see that your actually agent is working on Google Assistant also for you yourself, right? So you can actually create a bot for yourself and deploy it on Google Assistant, which just you are using, and you don't need to add any billing details or credit card details for that. So for example, I'll tell you, I have created a bot for myself, and what does it do is that I have created a custom alarm button where I have like saved a few links to different songs, and I have mentioned that in the morning like it should play these songs particularly for different bots, or like whenever I ask my bot to, let's say, remind me, it reminds me of. So you can create reminder applications on the bot itself, right? Now I think we have already over time, but yes, I think I'll just present the screen presentation for my last slide, which is resources. But yes, I think
well done session, Karan. We really liked. I especially got everything I was hoping to find in your session, and sure the audience have enjoyed as well. One thing I'd like you to do is share the presentation slides with us so we can send them to our audience. And I'm sure, and all the resources and links that you were showing during the demos.
Yes. So I think these are the resources. So I think whosoever like this, want to learn more, I think these are the quick links where I think cloud.google.com has a Dialogflow documentation. If you search Dialogflow ES documentation, enterprise version documentation, you can go through our basics videos and learn new concepts around, like different concepts around what are context and what are events where context actually gives memory to your bot, right? The bot is going to remember everything if you are enabling context. And then I think there are few code labs by Google developers which are already there, where you can create very basic bots like appointment scheduler bot, or let's say how to deploy your bot on Google Assistant. I think there are very basic bots which you can code labs which you can do. So I hope, I think I'll pass on these links, but you can actually continue working on these, and I think probably the team will post these links on the chat very soon after this session, and you can save this for future for learning Dialogflow. And I think that's all from the session. You can connect with me on LinkedIn if you want to, and if you have any further questions on Dialogflow or on bot creation. But I think these are the topics we have covered, and that's the resources section which all of you need to look. I think we are already over time, but just I think the last one or two questions I'll just answer. There's a question around, can we use Dialogflow in terminal or in any language terminal, as in, yes, you can work with Dialogflow when you actually are creating fulfillment. You can work with Google Cloud account and your terminal and write your fulfillment in any language. But I think for that, you need to converse and get introduced with Google Cloud. And I hope DevFest is offering you a session on Google Cloud as well. Armin is saying it's an interesting session. Thanks for your feedback. And I think you can let me know how you're, how did you find the session on the comment in the comments or on my LinkedIn profile. So I think that's all from my side.
I can certainly tell you now that your session was outstanding. I've certainly got everything I was looking for, and I really enjoyed the session. It was to the point, and I really enjoyed how you using all these tools and demonstrating it. And it was really nice having you here, and I really appreciate your contribution to our DevFest Islamabad 2020. And I hope all of us have learned from you, have good luck in their future endeavors and struggles, and they can obviously use what you have explained here for their personal benefit or for their professional uses. So thank you, Karan. Thank you so much for joining us.
And it was lovely to have you here. Thanks, everybody. Thanks.
Thank you.